I want to place a sound from the Secretary of State Hillary Clinton in Abu Dhabi, and I just want to get your reaction to what she had to say about this shooter.
Look, we have extremists in my country, a wonderful, incredibly brave young woman Congress member. Congresswoman Giffords was just shot by an extremist in our country. We have the same kinds of problems. So rather than standing off from each other, we should work to try to prevent the extremists anywhere from being able to commit violence.
Yeah.
Well, you know, I mean, I see the point she was trying to make and trying to encourage people in the Middle East to take responsibility for all the extremism that's there. But I think it's a sad commentary when you try to use an isolated criminal element of somebody who is obviously mentally disturbed and suggest that there's some society problem of extremism that's here. I mean, we don't have that kind of extremism. You can walk down the streets of the United States pretty safely everywhere, and you can't do that in many parts of the world. So I thought it was a poor choice of words by the Secretary of State. I kind of get her point, but I think they got to be careful. Just like it's wrong for Obama to run around the world to apologize for America. We are the best country in the world. We have the best record in the world. And there's no reason for us to apologize for being the great country that we are.
All right.
So I think that's the slippery slope that the president's gone on and Hillary Clinton's gone on, and I think it's wrong.
It doesn't surprise me that people from the right would be upset that people like myself and maybe people from the left and a whole lot of other people in America feel as I do that the anger that's purposely generated by people who make a living off of it serves one particular party better than the others. And it wouldn't surprise me if it continues at least through 2012.
I regret that you just made it so political in a way, Sheriff. People who suggest the climate that existed around her reelection campaign and some of the other things that were going on are in denial to suggest that those events are irrelevant to what happened, the tragedy that happened on the, you know, in the Safeway in your town the other night. But, Sheriff, do you want to change anything you said? Do you want to alter the record in any regard?
Not in any way, shape, or form. When you have people like Sharon Angle in Las Vegas running against Harry Reid, making outrageous statements such as...
You know, our founding fathers, they put that Second Amendment in there for a good reason, and that was for the people to protect themselves against a tyrannical government. In fact, you know, Thomas Jefferson said it's good for a country to have a revolution every 20 years. I hope that's not where we're going, but, you know, if this Congress keeps going the way it is, people are really looking toward those Second Amendment remedies. They're saying, my goodness, what can we do to turn this country around? And I'll tell you, the first thing we need to do is take Harry Reid out.
I don't know how to put that. There's an interesting juxtaposition there, John, of this frightening language about using gunplay to kill members of Congress if you don't like the way they're voting.
And for people like Sarah Palin to say, we have people like Gabby Giffords in our crosshairs.
I'm very pleased to see that Sharon Angle is doing so well and predict, of course, that she's going to be able to retire Reid as others across the country are working on that issue in addition to the issue of needing to fire Pelosi so that those gavels will be removed from the big government politicians and allow those with common sense, with a pro-private sector agenda, to be in more control of the policy and the vote.
Those statements are totally irresponsible, and they're not without consequences, and I think we may be seeing the fruit of it here.
Whether or not those statements, Sheriff, are irresponsible, I think the main beef against you is that they played no role in what should have been a briefing about a crime rather than your assessment of the current political climate.
Hate speech and other insightful speech is much more readily available to individuals than quite clearly it was 8 or 10 or 15 years ago, and that absolutely presents a challenge for us, particularly when it results in what would be lone wolves or lone offenders undertaking attacks.
Pima County Sheriff used a news conference yesterday to condemn the tone of political rhetoric lately. Listen to this.
I think it's time as a country that we need to do a little soul searching. Because I think it's the vitriolic rhetoric that we hear day in and day out from people in the radio business and some people in the TV business, and what we see on TV and how our youngsters are being raised, that this has not become the nice United States of America that most of us grew up in. And I think it's time that we do the soul searching.
Well, a lot of people expected a more straightforward law enforcement report when that sheriff stepped to the podium, but that's what they got. Joining us now is Juan Williams, Fox News political analyst. Juan, good morning to you on this Sunday morning, difficult day for the whole country.
Very, yeah, I'm telling you, it's very mournful here in Washington. It's clear that there's a pall over all we're doing, aside from the flags being at half staff, as you were pointing out, Martha.
Yeah. Let's take a look at, you know, a lot of this ranting and raving that he did on YouTube is getting a lot of attention as everybody tries to figure out what was going on in this young man's mind. Let's take a look at a piece of this, Juan. He says the majority of citizens in the United States have never read the United States of America's Constitution. And he goes on to say, you don't have to accept the Federalist laws. Nonetheless, read the State of America's Constitution to apprehend. And he goes on here, all of the current treasonous laws, you're literate.
I have no idea what the Tea Party is, okay? I have no clue. But what I'm a journalist who sits here and perhaps stupidly listens to the things that Tea Party politicians say in public that they are for. For instance, they say they are for the freedom of this country. They say they are for protecting the constitutional rights of this country. They say they are against having a corrupt government that does special favors for different special interests in this country. And I listen to those things and I sit in my living room and I think, you know what? I'm for all those same exact things.
I think it was surprising that the sheriff made that statement yesterday.
Now, should the sheriff have been saying what he said? Let me say that lots of people are saying what the sheriff said in the aftermath of the shooting, that they think that the tenor of political discourse in our country is at such a high level right now, and they worry that it's having some consequence in terms of people who are at loose ends, like this young man apparently was, therefore taking action. But he has no direct link.
All right, ready for this one, folks? It is the era of the, quote, Republican mean girls. At least that's what New York Times columnist Maureen Dowd thinks. Here's what she wrote. We are in the era of Republican mean girls, grown-up versions of those teenage tormentors who would steal your boyfriend and spray paint your locker and, just for good measure, spread rumors that you were pregnant. These women, Jan, Meg, Carly, Sharon, Linda, Michelle, Queenie Sarah, and sweet wannabe Christine, have co-opted and ratcheted up the disgust with that status quo that originally buoyed Barack Obama. Okay, so that's our starting point. Are you ready for this one?
We give you Michelle Bachmann in her own words.
You are now looking at a fool for Christ.
I want people in Minnesota armed and dangerous.
I know enough not to fight with a dump truck.
Now we've moved into the realm of gangster government. We have gangster government.
This is the crown jewel of socialism. This is socialized medicine.
If we allow this to happen, group marriage, polygamy, and things much worse may not be far behind.
We have seen an orgy. The government spent its wad.
What is it that Barack Obama really believes? I'm very concerned that he may have anti-American views. It's great just to be able to get my message out. And if I get under people's skin, so be it.
The closest he came, this is Clarence Dupnik, who's the sheriff of Pima County, the closest he came was to say, you know what, there's so much anti-immigrant, anti-government fervor, especially in that southern 8th district of Arizona, that he thinks it may have stirred people up. But he doesn't know that for a fact. And it's worrisome to me that, you know, you make these links because then it becomes so highly politicized, Martha.
Yeah, it does. And as you point out,
I wish the American media would take a great look at the views of the people in Congress and find out, are they pro-America or anti-America? I think people would love to see an expose like that.
He's hardly alone in kind of making these connections early on in this whole thing. And that is, it is disturbing. I mean, you want to look at this man, you know, and you read some of these things he's talking about. He clearly is unstable. So why do you think it is, Juan, that there's this sort of knee-jerk reaction to kind of say, oh, well, you know, that's all part of that, you know, Tea Party thing and kind of link it all together. Why is that?
First, Carl Paladino, the GOP candidate for governor of New York, said he didn't want children being, quote, brainwashed into thinking that homosexuality is acceptable. Then we learned that a Republican candidate for Congress likes to dress up like a Nazi in World War II reenactments. Well, I'll try explaining that proclivity to the voters.
Rand Paul's goon. You know, the guy in the video, he's demanding an apology from the woman that he kicked in the head. Former Rand Paul Bourbon County coordinator Tim Prophet, seen here with his old buddy Rand Paul, was interviewed by a local CBS affiliate in Lexington, Kentucky.
I don't think it's that big of a deal. I would like for her to apologize to me, to be honest with you.
Prophet, in my opinion, has lost all his marbles. Let's go back to the tape. Do you see the woman under his foot, folks? The woman that he just stepped on? The woman he gave a concussion to and sent to the hospital? And he thinks that she should apologize to him? What's wrong with these people?
Kind of link it all together. Why is that the inclination out there?
Well, there are a couple things going on here, Martha, and I think it's worth the time for us just to step back a second and realize that
this weekend's tragic shooting and assassination attempt of Representative Giffords has ignited a firestorm over the power of heated political rhetoric and whether it played some role in the violence. Jake Tapper.
To try to inflame the public on a daily basis, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, has impact on people.
And there is no shortage of examples of heated rhetoric.
And if ballots don't work, bullets will.
But Exhibit A for many Democrats is Sarah Palin, who last spring targeted for defeat Giffords' district and 19 others with this imagery. One columnist says she has blood on her hands.
Don't retreat, reload.
Giffords, for one, was not buying it.
We're on Sarah Palin's targeted list, but the thing is that the way that she has it depicted has the crosshairs of a gun sight over our district. And when people do that, they've got to realize there's consequences to that action.
Right-wing radio and some on TV, as he phrased it, responding by A, claiming left-wing political rhetoric comes in equal measure and at equal volume, though it does not, and B, the criticism of violent political rhetoric is itself politically motivated. Never mind that it was Giffords' father, when asked whether she had any enemies, who replied, quote, the whole Tea Party, unquote, or that Giffords herself had emailed a Republican friend on the eve of her shooting discussing ways to tone down the rhetoric, or that the FBI director said the internet has made the availability of hate speech a challenge, or that an anonymous senior Republican senator told Politico the shooting was a cautionary tale for Republicans. Quote, there is a need for some reflection here. What is too far now? Or that the Tea Party Express replies to this day's events with a fundraising email. Almost overlooked in all this was the Secretary of State speaking in and to the Middle East in the United Arab Emirates.
We have extremists in my country, a wonderful, incredibly brave young woman Congress member. Congresswoman Giffords was just shot by an extremist in our country. The extremists and their voices, the crazy voices that sometimes get on the TV, that's not who we are, that's not who you are.
National Journal reports tonight President Obama is likely to go to Tucson on Wednesday. And if the quintessential Americanness of the victims had not been clear, there was today the identical twin of the Congresswoman's astronaut husband, himself an astronaut, calling for an end to irresponsible words, calling for that even from the soundless void of space.
We have a unique vantage point here aboard the International Space Station. As I look out the window, I see a very beautiful planet that seems very inviting and peaceful. Unfortunately, it is not. These days, we're constantly reminded of the unspeakable acts of violence and damage we can inflict upon one another, not just with our actions, but also with their irresponsible words.
Political ideology aside, I think when it comes to what's in the best interests of the people of America, politicians have a responsibility to do that. And anybody with half a brain that's been watching what's been going on for the last 2 years knows that just the opposite is happening. And it's my feeling that the anger that is being purveyed by people in radio and some people on TV is done deliberately because it benefits one particular party.
As a sheriff, is it part of your job and part of your responsibility to assess a cultural environment that might increase the chances of injury and danger to your citizens?
I think that I have a legal responsibility to do that.
It is true. This is a deranged and almost a classic gunman in the American tradition of the tragic American tradition of violence. But still, he didn't go to a restaurant. He didn't go to a baseball game. He went to a congressional event.